Hello guys, my name is Muhammad and welcome to episode 1 of C++ tutorial series. So in this tutorial, we're going to talk about a little bit of what C++ is. So basically, C++ is a programming language that allows programmers to create their own applications, commercial applications, software that the world uses nowadays. So basically, C++ can be used to create programs, games, working softwares and all of that. And also C++ can be used to create AI, what I call artificial intelligence. So basically C++ is used to create PlayStation games. You know, PlayStation games, like if you play PlayStation, you'll notice that there are kind of amazing games like Call of Duty, Medal of Honor, GTA. All of that, some of that game I created with C++. So as you can see, that kind of power is given to C++, and you can use its standard library to create that kind of applications. As you can see, Linux, an operating system, is created by C++. Microsoft Windows that we use, that I'm using right now, is created with C++. As you can see, when you know C++, you can work in a lot of industries, a lot of places in this world right now. So you should learn this tutorial, and it will help you build your career in learning C++ and getting into the advanced level of C++. So basically, this tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can achieve that kind of success. So follow me step by step. I'm going to show you how you can build up to that kind of level. Of course, I cannot show you everything about C++, but I can show you the basics so that you can understand what C++ is by watching this kind of video. So to create C++ program, you need a compiler, right? So I already have my compiler, but I will show you where to get your compiler. So I think that all of you know what Google is, right? So you should go to Google, www.google.com, right? So when you go to Google, search for something like div C++ or code block. But as you can see, I'm using div C++, so I recommend that you download it, or you can also download code blocks, and some of the syntax are the same. So we have, when you download your div C++, you install it on your computer. When you install it, then you are good to go and you can watch this video. So we have our compiler, right? We have our div compiler. I will think that you have a compiler. So we're going to stack. So when you want to create your first C++ application, I recommend that you go to File, in the menu, then New, then Projects. So you click on Console Applications and click on C++ project and the name of your project. Name of project, C++. Tutorial, right? So we save it, right? And save it. Okay, I'll save it on my desktop and save this kind of program. So as you can see, I have my first C++ background. So create C++, we are going to use a lot of codes that will be used in the C++ application. I will do some certain functionality. So before we start, I would like to explain what this program is, but I will add some functions that are useful in our applications. So we use something like using namespace std. Statements. So as you can see, all this, we are not going to use them, so I'm going to get rid of them. I want you to get rid of them because we are not going to use them. So this is the first C++ program. So basically, I would like to explain what this guy does. So I will start with this guy. So this guy right here is called standard library or preprocessor. So this includes right here, will include the standard library. So use the hash then include then the name of the standard library. So standard library are basically an outside function or something that you can include in your file or in your program that will allow you to create or to do some side of functionality. So as you can see, this standard library name IOStream allows us to input and output stream in our program. So we can input something and then we can output with this IOStream. So the standard library that will allow us to do that. If we want to use calculation and advanced calculation, we're going to import the mathematics standard library. If we're going to use statistics, you have to import standard library of statistics. If you want to use networking, you can import the standard library that is used for networking with this hash and include and the name of standard library below. So as you can see, if you want to create a game, you have to import the standard library for creating game. So this standard library is very important and is used for creating huge applications. So we have this user namespace STE. So this basically import the built-in standard library. Using this STE means standard library. So it import the built-in standard library that I use for that code. So every C++ have a built-in standard library. So there are libraries that I use constantly in C++ programming. So without importing them, you cannot use some certain functionality in C++. So I believe that in every C++ code, you have to import this, otherwise the C++ program will not work. So import this user namespace STE and your program will definitely work. So we have the int. So this guy right here is called a function. So every C++ program have a main function. So this guy right here is a main function. So we have our integer, int, right? What integer is a data type in C++. What I mean by data type is that it allows us to, an int data type will allow us to work with values, import values and execute values. But what if we use string? Then it will use only strings. Well, if we use float, it will use the dot and all of that. So we have our int, a whole number, and we have our hello guys, right? We have int, main function, then curly brace. This curly brace is important. So within this curly brace, we put our program. So we have our quote, it's used to output something on the screen, right? Then we have our insertion or extraction operator, then the double quote, and the text or the string inside the double quote as hello guys. So we have the extraction operator and the end line. So what this end line means is that it's end a line, would go to the new line. So it definitely means go to the new line. So we will definitely go to the new line in this kind of program. So we have our code, then hello guys, then end line, right? So end line, then semicolon. So every statement inside a function must end with a semicolon. So all these guys right here inside this function called statements. So we have our main function, then curly brace, opening and closing curly brace. Then within that curly brace, we put all our statements. So this guy right here, return 0, terminate our program. It says that we have come to the end of our program. So when we compile this, we will see that it will output hello guys. We will save this. Yep. And when we run it, we'll see what will happen. So, definitely, we get our hello guys as the output of this code. If you definitely see this, you'll see that we have hello guys as the output of this code. So I definitely think that you're following me and you have your own system trying to write everything that I wrote right here, because that is when you'll get all the things that I'm trying to say. So we have this. So you must be thinking that, what the heck am I doing with all this kind of things, right? This. Why should I not put this code and then hello guys and then end line to print something on the screen? Why do I need each line of code just to print some certain things on the screen? So basically, these guys right here are very important to creating your applications. So without them, you cannot input something. So like I said, input IO stream allow us to output something and input it on the screen. So IO stream allows us to output this code and the hello guys. So as you can see, without this IO stream, we cannot output this guy right here. So we have to have the IO stream for us to work with output and input. So we have our curly brace and the main function, namespace and the include. I guess this is the end of this video. If you like this video, click on the like button. Otherwise, stay tuned for my next episode.